We've seen some pretty weird cases and we've built PCs in most of them, but the Cougar FV270 is like the boss rush mode for quirky cases. It has a curved tempered glass front panel, it's got a built-in sag bracket, it's got angled side intake fans, a hidden diagonal fan at the bottom, and it looks like it's riding a snowboard. Not to mention an add-on that lets you put a stage in the front for your favorite miniature, like our little Kush Darth Vader. We've seen all these elements work in other PC cases, but the question is, do they all add up to one harmoniously cool platform, or will they turn the FV270 into a hot mess? You know what? We're gonna find out right here, right now on Robeytech. What do you get when you take the angled fans of the NZXT H6 Flow, the angled glass panels of cases like the Height Y60 or MSI MAG Panel M100, and that funky front intake fan we saw in the NZXT H5 Flow? You get something that looks like a GNK droid from Star Wars. Jokes aside, what you really get is something that breaks convention and looks a lot cooler than a GNK droid. You get Cougar's newest PC case, the FV270. While it may look different, Cougar is no stranger to releasing PC cases that make a statement. I mean, we've done some incredible ones like our Cyberpunk 2077 build that you can see right here. Now, this one is available in black or white for $149.99, and let's find out what kind of statement the FV270 makes. Let's start with a tour on the outside of the case. The FV270 is huge, and we're not talking like Asus Hyperion huge, but it does rival the Fractal Design North XL in size. There is a good reason for that, but we'll get to that in just a bit. As for the actual measurements, the FV270 is about 20.2 inches or 530 millimeters long, 10.6 inches or 268 millimeter wide, and 20.2 inches or 512 millimeters tall. Like I said, it's big. For comparison, the FV270 is about as tall as a standard garden gnome, with its hat, of course. As far as weight goes, the FV270 weighs 30.86 pounds, or 14 kilograms. That's pretty hefty for a PC case, specifically given that the whole Corsair One weighs, what, 26 pounds? For comparison, the FV270 weighs about as much as a 50-inch TV, or an Icelandic sheepdog, whichever one you want to measure with. As for case I/O controls, the FV270 has two USB 3.0 ports, one Gen 2 Type-C port, as well as power and LED control buttons, and there's also a combined audio jack on the top as well. Inside the Cougar FV270, there's support for micro ATX, mini ITX, ATX, and EATX motherboards. Cougar is very clear in their marketing that they want this case to be ready just in case EATX motherboards become the new normal. Still don't think that's gonna be a thing. Now, in the same vein of compatibility, the FV270 does support back-connect motherboards like MSI's Project Zero or the new upcoming BTF motherboards from Asus. I think, you know what, an Asus ROG BTF in here would look sweet. Keeping with the theme of bigger components, the FV270 can fit GPUs up to 420 millimeters or 16.5 inches in length. That is if you don't have an AIO installed on the side. If you do, the space is limited to only 330 millimeters or about 13 inches. Since we're talking about GPUs, there is another thing that is actually pretty cool here. Check out the PCI mounts in the back. This whole bracket can be flipped to fit vertically mounted GPUs. But if you're worried about big GPUs sagging in a horizontally mounted situation like we have here, Cougar has you covered with a built-in anti-sag bracket. Don't get too attached to this. We're gonna talk a little bit about that later. Speaking of the things you do want to attach to, let's move on to fan support. The FV270 can fit up to three 120 millimeter fans at the top, two at the side, three at the case bottom, if you count the funky angled one, and one in the case rear. If you want to use 140 millimeter fans, you could fit up to two 140 millimeters at the top, side, and bottom of the case, as well as one in the case rear. Now, it is worth pointing out that the mounting point for the bottom fan aren't ideal. They get in the way of the cable path that could be used to run your GPU power cable. So you have to ask yourself if you want to pull hot PSU air into the case or have access to a slick cable run. I'm pretty sure I know which way we're going to choose every time. As for AIO support and radiator support, you can follow the same logic. 360 millimeter or 280 millimeter up top and 240 or 280 in the side and bottom. The same rules apply here for the bottom mounting of a radiator. You can, but it's not ideal. What is ideal is that if you wanted to use a tower style air cooler, you have about 180 millimeters or 7.1 inches worth of clearance to do that. That is plenty of space for amazing air coolers like the Cooler Master MA824, the Noctua NH-D15, or Corsair's A115. While the case doesn't have direct front air intake, that angled side fan, as well as the diagonal front fans, may just do the trick. Speaking of an angled fan, Cougar does sell an RGB plate that basically can replace the diagonal fan. In case builders want to do stuff like display one of their favorite Funko Pops or an action figure, etc., the center stage accessory, which I think is such a great name, costs around $25. We'll talk more about it a little bit later. Moving on to space for storage, there is a bracket in the back compartment that can fit either 2 3.5-inch drives or 4 2.5-inch SSDs, which is a lot. Since we're talking about space, the FV270 can support PSUs up to 250 millimeters or 9.8 inches in length. As for front panel connections, we need to give Cougar a huge round of applause. They did it, folks. They have succeeded where others have failed us. They gave us a unified front panel connector. And I'm gonna give you a huge round of applause for whipping that like button, slapping that subscribe button, and ringing that notification bell so that you don't miss videos like this one in the future. For real, you guys are awesome, and we are really grateful for all of you guys who watch these videos. The last thing we're gonna share about the inside here is that there is a ton of space for cable management. Typically, we warn people about running out of space, but it seems like Cougar has found like an access point to a pocket dimension where well-managed cabling can live in harmony, and the FV270 is the doorway to that happy place. Now, guys, it's time to see if the Cougar FV270 can put all of these features to good use. At idle, the FV270 averaged 27 degrees Celsius on CPU and 34 degrees Celsius on the GPU. Those averages send Cougar's latest case in competition with cases like the Fantex NV7, the Antech P20, and the Lianli O11 Evo, which is really good because those cases have some of our cooler temperatures. Under CPU load, the FV270 held CPU temperatures at 72 degrees Celsius. Those temps put it in line with cases like the Antech C5 and C8, the Lianli O11 Evo XL, and the NZXT H6 Flow, all cases averaging 72 degrees Celsius. As for our 1440p gaming benchmarks, the Cougar FV270 did the unthinkable. It averaged 43 degrees Celsius on the CPU and 57 degrees Celsius on the GPU, besting the NZXT H6 Flow. That's huge because the H6 was our coolest PC case tested last year. Bravo Cougar, the FV270 put on a great show. With numbers like these, I would say it's easy to close this one out. Call it dusted and done. But it wouldn't be a Robeytech Ultimate case review without sharing some of the things that you should think about when considering the Cougar FV270 as your PC case. Thing number one, the built-in sag bracket is a great addition on paper, but it will not work with all GPU and motherboard combinations. If you're planning on using a motherboard like the ASRock X670E Tai Chi or the MSI Z790 Carbon, where the topmost PCI slot is lower than many of the other motherboards, you're gonna have a bad time with the sag bracket if your GPU needs more than two PCI slots. It just won't fit. While it can be removed from the case, we do wish that there was a little better operating range for the GPU sag bracket. Thing number two, this case can be torn down to its bones. From removable filters and framing to side panels and PCI slots, the FV270 gives builders unhindered access to get where they need to. Heck, there are even toolless removable brackets at the top and bottom of the case. I can't tell you how happy that made the review team. Look, we know that fans and AIOs can be installed inside of the case, and the cableway shrouds can be worked around. But it's nice to have options, and options are the FV270's calling card. We did notice that some pieces required reinstallation before others to make things fit properly, specifically the top and side panels. But that could just be our case. It's just something to be aware of if you're gonna strip this thing down. Thing number three, the cable guard is really nice and does a really good job of hiding cables, but builders would need to be careful pulling cables through. There is a slight break between where the opening ends and the rest of the cable shroud that is a bit sharp. Putting tension on these cables at particular points could dig into the cables itself. So with that one, just take your time, watch out for cables getting snagged in the corner, and you'll be fine. And then thing number four, as cool as the center stage accessory is, you're gonna have to weigh the pros and cons of losing that front intake fan. The thermal performance was really, really good with that fan, but it's gonna be up to you if it's a sacrifice that you would make. We just wanna make sure you're aware that you shouldn't put any risk to your components just to add this accessory. Though, to be honest, with all of this airflow, even without that, I don't know if this is gonna be a really big issue. Even though we joked at the beginning about Cougar copying NZXT, Height, and MSI's homework, the FV270 really does take the best and most unique features of those cases, and then they've made something incredible out of all of it. You know, the FV270 is a bit punk rock riding on a snowboard, but with its cool temperatures, how easy it is to tear down, and its open space for larger components, plus a cool stage, this rebel of a PC case may have made a scene with its odd looks, But you know what? Honestly, we can get down with it. As we wrap this up, we want to give a huge shout out to obviously Cougar for letting us check out the FE270. But we want to know what you think about it. Do you like the case's funky design? Do you like and would you use a stage accessory like this? That, dude, he just looks so happy down there. You know what I mean? And then honestly, what kind of build would you put inside of it? To be honest, this build is, it's super sick. But let us know what you think down in the comments below. Now, while you're down there, go ahead and slap that subscribe button, whip that like button, and ring the notification bell so that you get a notification each and every time we post a video like this right here in Robeytech. And if you want to continue the conversation, talk about this case or any other case or any PC build, head over to our Discord server, discord.gg/Robeytech. Absolutely amazing place to talk about all these sorts of things with other like-minded tech and PC enthusiasts. And you know what? You know, you might just make a friend. Outside of that, make sure you follow me on all the other social media platforms at Robeytech, absolutely everywhere. Thank you so much for watching this video, and we look forward to seeing you on the next one.